let's talk about the best books for creatives and artists, because we are facing somewhat of a problem at the moment. Most people in life on this planet, 86% of people to be more precise, can read. Yet most people are illiterate. Why? Because most people who can read never really do. They never go beyond the traditional Facebook message or the occasional message of a friend or the New York Times best-selling cookbook recipe or whatever. And that's a problem, because the truth is that nobody becomes a successful artist by reading cookbook recipes, you know? Like, that's just not how it goes. So let's talk about the best books for artists. And let's start off with the first one on this list. And this one is a strange one, because you will normally not really find this on a list of top art books or a list of best books for artists, because initially, it has nothing to do with art. I'm talking about this one over here. Rich Dad, Poor Dad. Now, for me, this book is about making money as an artist, which is kind of important, because if we look at the artist's problems, the most common problem in the art world is people who don't know how to make money, people who don't know how to make themselves financially free. And so this is a really important book. And the interesting thing about this book is that it's compiled out of two voices. So on one hand, we have the voice of a university professor. He's really rational. He gives advice to this persona in the book, and the advice is very good. The advice is actually very good. And that is the poor dad. It's his actual dad. And then there's another dad, a rich dad. And the advice also sounds rational. It's just a different type of advice. And throughout the book, you will see that one type of advice leads to poor existence, and the other type of advice leads to a rich existence. And the interesting thing about this book is that you will see and recognize the advice of a poor dad. You will see and recognize it. A lot of times, especially in the space of artists, the advice that we get from parents, the advice that we get from teachers, the advice that we get from other artists are very similar to the advice of the poor dad, the academic professor in this book. And so it's very interesting to read that and see, like, hey, wait a minute, this is the advice that I've followed to some extent, and it led to this place, this position that I have now. Perhaps I should take this other advice into account as well. And so this book is just really important. If you're an artist and you kind of need to learn how to make money as an artist, this book will be of impeccable importance. Let's go further. The fourth one on this list is one of the best art business books out there, a true art business book. Yet again, it's not really listed as one of the best art books, because initially, again, like the previous one, it doesn't really have that much to do with art. But for me personally, it has everything to do with art. It's a book about how to become a famous artist. Now, we're talking about the tipping point of Malcolm Gladwell. In this book, Malcolm Gladwell tries to kind of figure out how virality originates. What is responsible for an artist to go viral? What is responsible for his fame? What is responsible for a song to become, etc., etc.? And so he doesn't focus on likes on Facebook or whatever. He focuses on the real psychology. Which type of people do you need in order to carry your name? And so this is a very, very important book. While reading this book, you will understand the importance of connectors, of market mavens, of sneezers, of what art collectors in terms of your name, in terms of your personal brand will actually do. It's not just the buying, selling art that is going on there. It's the branding. It's the totality of it all. And so for every art career, you know, if you're a musician, which people will actually have an impact when they talk about your music? In my humble opinion, this should be one of the great art books, because it's dealing with such an important topic for all artists. Now, if you want to know more, or if you want to already dive in into some kind of introduction in the book, I have one video that covers an idea that is covered in that book. It's called How to Become a Famous Painter, and it deals with the connector and what impact the connector has on your art career. You can check it out. It's linked up somewhere on the screen. Okay, the third one on this list, The War of Art by Steven Pressfield, is one of the best books on creativity and innovation. Why? Because it deals with the psychology. It deals with the psychological barriers that all artists face. It deals with that moment in time, no matter what you're creating, whether it's a painting, whether it's a book, whether it's a piece of music or a conversation or a relationship or whatever you create in your life. When you're creating, there's a moment in time before the creation where you will doubt, where you might talk yourself out of it, where you might already screw up, where you might, etc., etc., etc. And it deals with that moment in time. It deals with that, with the psychology of it. And so this is just for all levels, all types of artists. Is this just one of the most essential books for artists? No doubt about it. Steven Pressfield, The War of Art. Check it out. Before we go on to the fourth one on this list, let me explain you a little bit, because I'm saying here like best books for creativity and innovation and all of that stuff. Like, you have to understand the following thing about me. Because I'm fairly young, actually, you know, like I'm in my late 20s. So it's not that I've had a lifetime of reading. No, I'm too young for that. But here's the thing. So I only read nonfiction. I read an hour and a half a day at least, and I read daily. It's part of my morning routine. And so I'm young, but I do read a lot. I do read a lot. When I say this is one of the best books or one of the most essential books for artists, you can be assured that I've read a lot of them. I've read a lot of them. And is it the best one? I don't know. Of course not. Nobody can claim that. But it's just going to be a good book for you to read. So let's go on to the fourth one on this list. The fourth one on this list is the one over here, Living Forward. This is one of the best books for aspiring artists. And the younger you are, the better this book will be. Or the most impact that this book will make. Here's the thing that I've noticed. When I look at people, at artists, what I see is, for example, when they're going to the supermarket, they will know exactly what they need. They will have planned the supermarket visit for the dinner that they are giving or for whatever. They know exactly what they need. When they're going on vacation, they plan their vacation. You know, when whatever they're doing, they're planning, they're making a plan, and then it happens approximately according to plan. You know? And if they don't make a plan, don't make a grocery list, and they go to the supermarket and they don't get everything they need, they're not surprised. That's how life goes, you know? Like, if you don't make a list, you're gonna miss out on some stuff. You're gonna forget some stuff. That's how it goes. But here's the catch. Most of those make a plan for their supermarket visit, but they don't plan their art career. And that's a very strange thing. They don't plan their art career. They don't have a list of what they want to get from life in the next 2 years. They have a list from what they want to get from the supermarket. That's strange, you know? And then they go through life and then they're surprised that they're not getting the things that they want. Of course not. Just like with going to the supermarket, you are going to forget particular things. You know, if you don't have a list, if you don't have a plan, you're going to forget some things. And so planning your art career is a crucial thing. It's super important. And it's something that I didn't do that in the beginning. And it's definitely something that, oh man, it's so powerful. And so the sooner you start doing that, the sooner you will get the benefits from that. And that self-fulfilling prophecy kind of thing that starts to, you attract particular things, you know? And so this book is about planning. This book is about how to plan your life, how to live forward. And so I'm not sure if it's the best book on planning. It's actually the only book on planning I've read. So feel free to check out another book on planning. But I know this one is a good one. And it was recommended to me by somebody that I trusted. And so it's definitely a good one to check out. And anyway, you just have to learn how to plan. Now, the last book on this list of best books for artists is probably one of the best art business books out there. And it's titled The Value of Art by Michael Findlay. I don't know if I pronounce his name correctly. But anyway, this book is so important because when I talk to artists, a lot of times I see friendly people. A lot of times I see amazing people who are following a passion And sometimes already for a very long time, they make great sculptures, great paintings, great everything. Just, it's so powerful. And a lot of times they have a hard time because they chose the art business. They chose something that's just inherently really difficult. And so I have a lot of compassion with that as well, because it's just hard, and I know how hard it is. And the problem is that most of them, even though they make so like they're great people, most of them don't really understand the art market. When I talk with artists, sometimes I'm flabbergasted. I'm just astonished how many don't know anything about the art market. They just don't know the basics. They don't know how it functions. And so this book, in that sense, is great because it explains everything, or approximately everything around that. Like, you will understand how it all plays out, what functions collectors have, galleries, just the whole thing. It covers everything in a very deep way. It's not a basic book, like with only basic stuff or anything. And so yeah, I think those are important. I often get reminded about this quote, reading great art books is like dreaming with your eyes wide open. And I love that for some reason. And if you choose, or if you read this book, if you read this book, it's like choosing to dream about selling art, to dream about pricing art, to dream about art collectors and the strange financial constructions in the art market, and really understand that roughly. And that's important for any artist. And so yeah, I hope this list was valuable to you. Check it out. If you want to know more about selling art or art business related stuff, I have a lot of videos on that on this channel. You can check them out as well. And I hope to see you again on this channel, but that's up to you. My name is Dries Ketels. I'm an artist, and I'm just here to help you out. Learn, grow through books. That's going to be amazing. See you later. Okay. Ciao, ciao.